How are we doing, everybody? And welcome back to One Big Question with Father Pete and Lynnette. But today, I am your sole host, Lynnette, as Father Pete is on his way back with the men's basketball team. But don't worry, I know you're all watching for me anyway, so you get the true star. Today, we're talking all about how the pandemic, it's been around for a year, and the likelihood of reinfection. We're seeing cases of reinfection from spring, summer, even fall of 2020. How common is it? Are these cases different than previous cases? We've got a lot of questions, but the one big question is, can I get reinfected? My guest today is our first repeat guest, Mark Fox, who is the Deputy Health Officer of St. Joseph's County. Mark Fox, how are we doing?
I'm great, Lynnette. Good to see you.
Awesome. Dr. Fox, it's so good to have you back, and I'm excited about this because I know you are such an expert, and that's why we asked you back.
Glad to be here.
So my first question is, we have a lot of data available to us on the HERE dashboard about kind of the cases at Notre Dame, what the situation is. But since we have you, I was wondering how the county's looking, how the community around Notre Dame is doing with COVID.
You know, we have to look at it in context. As you said, the pandemic's been going on for a year. It was actually a year ago today that we announced the first case in St. Joseph County.
Wow.
Same time that WHO announced a pandemic. So, you know, it's a momentous day, and it's been quite a year. When we look at things in context, you know, our worst period in St. Joseph County was right before Thanksgiving. You know, it was 2 weeks after Halloween when we were at our peak in terms of cases and hospitalizations. Our deaths in October, November, and December were the highest, you know, at any time in the pandemic. And things have gotten, you know, the general trajectory has been dramatically better since then. Having said that, we've really kind of plateaued. We aren't getting a whole lot better. We'll occasionally see little blips, but we have, you know, about 70 new cases a day in St. Joseph County. And there for a while, the first couple weeks back, Notre Dame accounted for a big chunk of those. 35 to 40% of the cases in the county in the early part of middle of February, say, were related to the Notre Dame campus. Fortunately, the campus situation has improved from what it was those first few weeks, but there's still a significant amount of COVID cases diagnosed each day on campus.
Wow, okay. I had heard that Notre Dame was a big part of the cases, so it's interesting to actually hear the numbers. And speaking of that, and there's a lot of rumors saying, in the beginning we thought, once you get it, you're done. But can you kind of clarify that? How common is it to get reinfected? Because clearly it's possible. We've seen cases here on campus and throughout the world. So how does that, maybe not how it happens scientifically, but how common is it?
Yeah. Honestly, I think we don't have a great handle on that. We know that, you know, having been infected before offers some level of immunity that we think lasts for about 90 days. That's why you get a get out of jail free card for 90 days after an infection. And so, you know, we had started to see reinfections late in the fall. So in that November timeframe, where it was mostly among people who had been out 4 or 5 months from their initial infection. So people who had been infected in the summer, you know, were re-exposed and got infected again in the fall. Actually, now it's actually, to tell you the truth, it's Notre Dame students who are most commonly reinfected. And again, part of it is just the timing of the semester. A lot of students got infected, you know, with the outbreak in August. Now we're at the perfect window for them to be reinfected. So we say there's a 90-day window of protection. In the county, we've seen a reinfection in as little as about 2.5 months. Most of them are at about 4 to 5 months. So there are a lot of students infected in the fall semester who are certainly at risk now. And, you know, because of the surveillance testing on campus, we're identifying, you know, a lot of reinfections and more than what we're seeing in the county as a whole. But the university is doing so much more testing than the rest of the county. So that's why we're picking up so many on campus.
Yeah, that makes perfect sense. But it's good to hear from you that reinfection is real, and because I know there's a lot of rumors, but coming from you, people have to believe it now, right? So kind of
as they're not my daughters, they maybe they'll believe it.
Yeah, except for any of your kids, they'll never believe you. So as vaccine distribution ramps up and more people are being vaccinated, optimism is growing. What do you say to people? And I'm sure you get this question all the time. What do you say when people ask you, when is this going to be over?
You know, I'm really, yeah, my girl's got that from me too. So I am really excited that, you know, by June, you know, every adult in America will have had the opportunity to get vaccinated. So that's a fantastic timetable. Again, it still doesn't mean you get a get out of jail free card, but I do think it will provide much more opportunity for more normal interaction, especially with other people who are vaccinated. And, you know, it's hard to know exactly what, you know, next academic year will look like, but I think it will look closer to a normal year than what we've had over this past year. Certainly, fingers crossed.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, that's optimistic. And the whole, hopefully everyone will have it available by June. I know that makes me sleep better at night. So kind of my last question, and it has to do a lot with the possibility of reinfection and spikes, St. Patrick's Day, especially for us ND kids. What is your advice on celebrating?
Yeah, you know, the campus in this town takes St. Patrick's Day very seriously. I think we're at a really, really pivotal point in the pandemic now, especially because we know that the variant exists in Indiana. I think people ought to act and make decisions and behave as though, you know, anyone in their circle could be infected with the variant. So, you know, our cases aren't going down in the county. They're up a little bit. Even over the last couple of days, our cases on campus are up a little bit. So I think it's kind of the perfect storm. We're going to have relatively nice weather this weekend, St. Patrick's Day, next weekend, nice weather for March in northern Indiana. Hopefully that means people will be celebrating outside. So outside celebrations, certainly much, much safer than indoor celebrations. But we have a lot of opportunity to blow it, right? I mean, we could wind up in a situation where the campus looks dramatically worse in a week or 10 days based on the decisions that people make this weekend and how they celebrate St. Patrick's Day. So I sound like a broken record. I would urge people to keep their bubble small, celebrate outside, keep your mask on, maintain your physical distance, because we could have a lot of fun, but we also could really screw things up. And so the campus situation could look dramatically worse in 10 days based on how you celebrate.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for coming on, and thank you for their advice. I know that a lot of people are trying to get things back to normal, but you're absolutely right. We have a lot of responsibility here to celebrate safely. So thank you so much. And for everyone watching, make sure you're following us along on Instagram and on Twitter at Notre Dame. Send us your questions so that we can answer them here on One Big Question. Have a great week, enjoy the weather, and go Irish.